So let's start looking at a few examples of ocean routes in this chapter. The first one that we'll start with is the North Atlantic Sea Route. So North Atlantic jo sea route hai, it's basically so the Atlantic Ocean is the one that's between continent of America and Europe on this side. So unke beech mein ocean aata hai, that's the Atlantic Ocean. So ye North Atlantic Sea Route jo hai, it's situated exactly over there. It basically connects Northern America and the West European region. And the reason why we start with this one is that it's because it's the most important trade route and it's the busiest trade route, right? So let's examine this for a second here. The North Atlantic Sea Route links Northeast US, this is Northeast, so Northeast USA to Northeast Europe, which happen to be the two most industrially developed regions. तो इसका मतलब क्या है और इसका सिग्निफिकेंस क्या है. तो जो नॉर्थ, तो यूएस इज अ कंट्री विच इज वेरी वेरी इंडस्ट्रियली डेवलप्ड एंड सो इज नॉर्थ वेस्टर्न यूरोप. जो यूरोप के जो यू नो द मोर डेवलप्ड स्टेट्स आर द वंस दैट आर इन नॉर्थ वेस्टर्न यूरोप. तो ओवर सीज इज द नॉर्थ अटलांटिक सी रूट हेल्प्स इन यू नो trade between the two most developed industrially developed regions of the world. So since ye dono hi bahut zyada industrially developed regions hai aur inke beech mein trade bhi isliye bahut zyada hota hai aur so that is what makes this trade route so busy. The North Atlantic Sea Route has 1/4 of the world's foreign trade and it's the busiest. तो पूरे 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 वर्ल्ड में जितना भी फॉरेन ट्रेड होता है ये उसका 1/4 जो है वो इस रूट के थ्रू होता है. विच मीन्स व्हाट, विच मीन्स 1/4 ऑफ द वर्ल्ड्स फॉरेन ट्रेड हैपेंस बिटवीन दीज टू एरियाज, बिटवीन दीज टू रीजन्स, बिटवीन नॉर्दर्न, बिटवीन द कंट्री ऑफ अमेरिका, बिटवीन द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका एंड बिटवीन यू नो countries of northwestern Europe. That's what it says. It says ki the 1/4 of the world's foreign trade happens across this trade route, and which makes this the busiest of all trade routes, also called the big trunk route because of the excessive amount of trade that happens in because of its because of its important as a trading route. The sea route is also called the big trunk route. This route has highly advanced ports and labor facilities at both the coasts, which is very natural kyunki jo dono regions hai dono hi bahut developed hai, bahut hi they have reached levels of modernization that other regions of the world are only trying to reach, are only trying to be that good. And so that is why these two regions have very very highly developed ports and labor facilities at both these ends. This route serves maximum countries and people as in compared to other trading routes. This is it's the busiest and it's also the most far reaching. It serves more ports of the countries. It serves more countries and more people of these countries than any other trading route. The important ports are located along the sea route are Port Said, Aden, Mumbai, Colombo and Singapore. So Port Said is in it's somewhere in Egypt, right? So this is in Egypt. Aden is a port of Yemen. Mumbai, you already know, it's in India. Colombo is in Sri Lanka. This is something that you probably didn't know. So Colombo is a very important port in Sri Lanka. Singapore is a city state of its kind. It's an island city state. So these are the important ports along this trading route. So the important thing to know about it, it's It links, areas of northeastern USA to northeastern Europe, which are the two most industrially developed regions. ये अपने में ही it has an implication कि how important the trading route is or how busy it remains. Also, 1/4 of the world's foreign trade happens across this route, which again establishes the fact कि ये कितना busy trading route है और कितना important है. It is also called the Big Trunk Road, and it has highly advanced ports and labor facilities at both the ends. And you have to remember, some of the like every other thing that we have studied in this chapter, you have to remember some examples of some ports that fall along this the sea route, right? So moving on, next we look at the Mediterranean Indian Ocean route. अब ये कहाँ पे है? So जो मेडिटेरेनियन एरिया है यूरोप का और जो इंडियन ओशन है जो बिल्कुल इंडिया के नीचे वाला जो वाटर बॉडी है सो दैट्स द इंडियन ओशन. सो द मेडिटेरेनियन इंडियन ओशन रूट कनेक्ट हाईली इंडस्ट्रियलाइज्ड वेस्ट यूरोप टू वेस्ट अफ्रीका, साउथ अफ्रीका, साउथ ईस्ट एशिया एंड कमर्शियल agriculture and livestock economies of Australia and New Zealand. So this is Australia and this is New Zealand, right? So if you form a mental image of a map, you can imagine ki jo Mediterranean region hai, matlab jo West European region hai, wahan ke jo Mediterranean areas hai, wahan se ye route nikalta hai via ocean, but basically traveling towards जो अफ्रीकन कॉन्टिनेंट है वहां पे हम वेस्ट अफ्रीका, साउथ अफ्रीका वो सारा घूम के हम आते हैं इंडियन ओशन में. सो वी मेक दिस रियली बिग. अब नाउ वी हैव दिस यूएस कनाल, सो नाउ द जर्नी हैज बीन शॉर्टेड उस एरिया से. इफ वी वांट टू ट्रेवल फ्रॉम और इफ वी वांट टू हैव ट्रेड विद वेस्ट यूरोपियन कंट्रीज, सो दैट बेसिकली हैपन्स थ्रू द यूएस कनाल. बट देन earlier, before the development of Suez Canal, this route was very, very important, and it came via the Atlantic Ocean hai, usi ke paas se ye nikal ke fir Africa ke niche se aake, then it reached Southeast Asia, jo Asia ka jo southeastern part hai, where we have countries like Philippines and all those Southeast Asian countries, जो SARC वाले countries हैं हमारे पास, and also it reaches the commercial, agriculture and livestock economies of Australia and New Zealand. Okay, so Australia and New Zealand are two economies जहाँ पे commercial agriculture होता है, मतलब agriculture which is meant for commercial purposes. और commercial agriculture में क्या होता है, जो भी एग्रीकल्चर होता है या जो भी फार्मिंग होती है उसको मतलब वो पर्सनल कंजम्पशन के लिए नहीं होता है, दैट इज मोस्टली फॉर कमर्शियल पर्पसेस, दैट इज मोस्टली फॉर बीइंग सोल्ड इन द मार्केट, राइट? सो कमर्शियल एग्रीकल्चर और लाइव स्टॉक का भी बहुत ज्यादा लाइव स्टॉक इज ऑल्सो हार्वेस्टेड एट हायर देन मोस्ट अदर रीजन्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. So these are two countries where this happens, the commercial agriculture and livestock economies of Australia and New Zealand, and this makes these two countries important for trading purposes, and that's where the relevance of the Mediterranean Indian Ocean route comes. So this is how the ocean route is spread across the world. So it starts from the Mediterranean area of West Europe, and then it traverses through areas near South, West Africa, and then South Africa, and then the Indian Ocean, where it reaches the Southeast Asian countries, where it serves the Southeast Asian countries and the two countries Australia and New Zealand. Okay, so the volume of trade between East and West Africa is on the rise due to the development of rich natural resources such as gold, diamond, copper, tin, groundnut, fruits, oil palm and coffee. So East or West Africa ki beech mein jo trade hai, so if trade needs to be done between East and West Africa, this happens through this route. It just travels like this. So this trade is basically on the rise due to all these important natural resources, gold, diamond, ये सारे valuable natural resources है जो जिनके लिए for which we have really high demand. So gold, diamond, copper, tin, groundnut, fruits, oil, palm, and coffee. And also, you know, if we talk about these are important metals which are always in demand, and the rest of them we can, you know, these are like spices and fruits and stuff like coffee have been important items of trade since very, very earlier periods. So that's what I say. So another relevance of the sea route here is the trade between West and East Africa itself. The last thing about this trading route is, before Suez Canal, this route connected ports of Liverpool and Colombo. So like I was saying, ki ab hamare paas Suez Canal hai, to ab ye route itna zyada relevant nahi raha when it comes to, you know, trade between Western European region and African region or the Asian region. But then before the Suez Canal had been operational, this was the route that connected. So Liverpool is in, you know, England. So it's like in northwest England, and Colombo, like we discussed earlier, it's in Sri Lanka. So you can imagine ki kitna kitna far-reaching tha ye sea route aur kitni relevant thi hai us time pe. From England, which is, you know, which is in United Kingdom, ye route extend hota tha all the way to Colombo, which is like in Sri Lanka, which falls on the Indian Ocean. To wahan se wo pura ghum ke aata tha. So this route was very, very, even though it was longer, even though, kyunki Suez Canal jo hai wo hamare traveling distance ko short kar deta hai, wo it's like a shortcut over the ocean route. This is a more longer route, but then at one point of time it was very important, it was very relevant, right? Because then we didn't have that shortcut, and this was the only route that was there. So these are the first two examples that we studied, the North Atlantic Sea Route, which was which is one of the most important sea routes that we have, one of the most busiest ones, and the Mediterranean Indian Ocean route, which has, even though it has lost a lot of its significance at present times due to the Suez Canal, but still it's kind of a really important route, and you should try and practice mapping all these ocean routes, because you need to know, at least that you need to know are important trading points of these routes, important ports of these routes, right?